said goodbye, Great Britain, but actually went to a greater place, Iceland. Yeah, my voice is like this because before I go, I already got a bad cold. And I went there, it was so cold, it can't compare to Britain. And then it's getting worse. After I arrived there, I realized there's no train. So I can't travel far. So in Iceland, it's better to have a car you can drive or have a bus tour with some tour agent. But I don't want to do that. I found some interesting places I want to go. There's one cave I want to go, so I took 1 hour bus and then walked by myself in the wilderness for 1 hour.
They drop me like in the entrance of the expressway. Then I go through under the tunnel there, and then all the road was like this, and I'm the only one here. I feel abandoned.
Well, I will say, it's me abandoned the world.
It's actually a lovely place. Not many tourists will came here. So I just choose a random place to call it. Nice Google map. So I need to carefully go past through here to arrive there. Here's a sign in case of slippery. I already slept over.
But when I see the cave, I don't dare to go in by myself. So I called my friend to do a video call so that I feel there is someone with me. When I walk back, there is still no one. I feel this is the only place that in the world only I know. Then I met a couple outside of the church. Then we said, oh, we can go see the northern light together. So they gave me a lift. Though that night we didn't see northern light because of the cloud, but we found a good place for a foot bath. It's for free. And the manager there is a super cute cat.
I
just mentioned the cat, and the cat come over. The second day, they kindly gave me a lift again. We went to north, went to the peninsula together. It rained so heavily and everything was really foggy, so we can't see the mountain just in fog. And I'm super lucky they're professional photographers and they took a lot of good pictures for me. On our way back, just by a snow mountain, we saw the northern light. Then, the third day, they gave me a lift again. We went to Blue Lagoon together. Then, we went to the lamb soup place again. This is my second time to drink it. This time I had fish soup, and there's a wall. If you drink more than 10 bowls, you can be on the wall. And the champagne drink 18 bowls. I had 4 bowls. In the hostel, the reception has a bar and it was amazing. There's a Latin party that night. People were dancing and I met a lot of Icelandic friends from there. A girl taught me how to dance a little bit. Then I met 3 cute girls. We went to a hot dog place. They said it was really good, so we went together. And we had a dinner together. Next day, one of them was still there, so we were on a road trip to Golden Circle. It was raining so badly, and we need to go down to see the things, so we just walk in the rain.
Geothermal National Park. Hi guys, we are at Geothermal National Park, waiting for a geyser to arrive. That one.
Second stop is a creature. And the time just driven by the snow mountain, Viva La Vida. And on our way, we just stop in a random place to see the view. The waterfall amazed me, the magic of nature. Then we went to a tomato farm, also a restaurant recommended by another girl. And that night, I went to an adventure. Because I feel Blue Lagoon is more human-made, but I want to find a hot spring made by nature. It was so pretty when we walked into the mountain and so many stars. It's funny that Ben brought his head torch and laser light. And in their American way, it's called flashlight.
It'll show the laser.
And we did find a hot spring, and it was super hot.
Wow, look at the northern lights.
So he studied astronomy. He said, "I know most of the stars."
It's got a funny name. It's called Booties.
And later we see the northern light in the mountain. He kept saying I'm crazy. Then the next day, we went to find a cave. I'm crazy, do you want to go to a cave?
Hopefully we'll be fine. If we didn't come out within five hours, maybe we need some help.
It's super cool that it's a lava cave. And it's only in Netherlands, in Iceland, sorry.
Okay. Keep going.
I can take it. Smoking the cave.
It's full with the lighter.
And I shouldn't talk about the movie The Descent. It scared me to death. When I suddenly heard some sound from almost close to the entrance or from the dark, I even ran away for a bit. Then there were two other tourists.
What time?
They tried to explore the cave.
Just howling just now.
We're out from this. We didn't go down there.
That's the clouds there. We're safe.
Broken soul has been cured in this gloomy place. Just the things I could.